I'm Thomas Bauer. I'm with the Fraunhofer Institute for Experimental Software Engineering in Kaiserslautern, Germany. And today I will talk about our virtual validation method, which is called Virtual Architecture Development and Simulated Evaluation of Software Concepts with the tool framework Feral. So this is joint work with my colleagues Adam and Donald. So today I will give some insights of the method and also of the tool, also with some concrete examples. So basically, when we look at the development process of today's complex systems, we usually need a systematic process model for that. So everybody's aware of that, with dedicated specification design techniques, top-down approach. We have the integration and the testing activities, which are basically conducted in a bottom-up way. And usually these things are quite expensive here due to the, let's see, late test stages and the late possibilities for detecting the critical issues in complex systems. Yeah, and usually nowadays, many systems are developed by integrating existing parts. So the main innovations, the majority of the new features is realized by the system integration. So basically this integration part and the higher level activities in these processes, they become more important here. In the basically in the technical systems, we see then, or we have a tight connection of the actual test objects and the environment. So we need then dedicated facilities for that here, especially then to for checking software models and the hardware. So we have the hardware loop simulation. Basically, then it's the integration of a control unit with its environment. And so we have further techniques here. So what we basically aim at is to validate things, validate properties as early as possible in the process. Yeah. So this is then realized by so-called shift left, and basically by using different kinds of models and different kinds of validation approaches. So basically here then the possibility of already checking software, checking models early, also in connection with the environment, so then basically in the loop. Yeah. So basically for today's systems and the challenges, we have to consider additional paths. So just, let's say, using models as some representatives of a system and then applying them for studying properties by analysis or verification is not enough. If we really aim at this new complex system, really this digital ecosystems, smart ecosystems, we have to go one step further here in order to really make sure that the new concepts, the new features, the new innovations are feasible with a current setup. So that's why additional stages are added here. We call it here this requirements loop simulation, basically at the early stages of development process, when you basically define your requirements, you define the drivers for the architectural decisions, you have to validate already if this is feasible. You have taken certain decisions already, and you have to check if it's really feasible, and you need infrastructure for that. Yeah. For the other phases here, basically for, let's see, testing on the model level, software component level, and later on also for the hardware, dedicated infrastructure and tooling is available. But for the aspect of integrating different systems from different domains, from different classes, yeah, so heterogeneous systems, this really a new topic. Yeah. So basically what we did at the Institute was that to develop a dedicated tool framework that explicitly addresses this stage and the challenges of the early validation and the coupling of different systems and different executable artifacts in order to enable an early virtual validation, really with pure virtual setup, virtual components, virtual environment. So that's our approach here and the corresponding tool, Feral. the features in a nutshell. So FERAL stands for the framework for the evaluation on requirements and architecture level. So you see here, really, we are focusing at the earlier stages here. It's about modeling and design, but it's not another modeling tool for specific aspects. It's really that we support different kinds of simulation models, yeah, with respect to the degree of abstraction, the behavior types, and also the degree of details here. And another thing is that we are able to couple different tools. We are a platform for coupling tools, for coupling simulators, also for enabling co-simulation. Yeah, so there are also the different means here. For example, by a generic NECDOT connection via UDP or TCP or via shared memory, also tool-specific connectors. So these are available. Currently, also there are a set of tool connections already implemented, for example, for Simulink or SystemC. So basically here, then, we are enabling a focused validation on specific abstraction, on a specific abstraction level here. Here, especially the validation on the based on high-level requirements and architectural concepts. Yeah. And so we are able to provide prototypes that can be used for the verification. Yeah, executable prototypes that really need to assess properties that really needs to be that needs to be tested, that cannot be analyzed. Yeah, the analysis of requirements. Yeah. Is still there, but you can really get confidence on your concept, on the new features, if you have an executable environment you can really use and for the validation. You can use it then also for dedicated XNOOP activities, here especially on the higher levels, basically requirements, system architecture level, yeah, and for the simulation, for the simulator coupling and the connector here, we are able then also to flexibly connect different tools here. That's really the advantage, really flexible tools. You do not have to rewrite the models, change everything. Really existing work, existing tools, existing expertise can be integrated here, yeah, to really assess your system design concepts, explore the design space, and really enable a more holistic evaluation at an earlier level. Yeah. So basically, that's the FERAL features in a nutshell here, so that we're really able to enable a reliable validation of the complex systems by integrating different heterogeneous components, also enabling a holistic testing with respect to specific goals, yeah, in a fully virtual environment. Yeah, so that's basically the FERAL nutshell. Here's some USPs. I will maybe highlight the relevant ones here. For example, if you want to connect black box models here, yeah, due to, for example, IP protection, yeah. So basically, you are an OEM, you're an integrator, you would like to check already executable artifacts from your suppliers. So then the question is how to integrate black box models. Yeah, in many cases, you really need them locally, or you need to have you need to access them. So here we are able with our infrastructure to connect remotely to black box simulation models and also other tools. Yeah. Or for example, if you want to check specific non-functional requirements early, then you can do this by adding, of course, the dedicated models. If you're interested in performance, you need to have a model that provides the performance properties. But here with the FERAL framework, you are able to execute them and validate them. Yeah. Or for example, if you want to set up a simulation scenario fast, yeah. So here you get the means by connecting different components together with dedicated communication middleware. Yeah. Or also you can just add another conceptual behavior model here, because it's a component that is still not exist. You can add them a behavior model here of different notations and just connect it to the other parts in order to really run the validation. So there are really advantages here that facilitate an earlier validation of the system. Yeah? So these are the main benefits. So in order to support that, we have created a library also of simulation components, where we basically cover different aspects here, for example, different semantic models. So basically also you can then integrate components which are event triggered or which are time triggered, discrete time, continuous time. Yeah? You can use directly dedicated behavior models. Yeah. You can connect to a specific to executables in different languages, for example, Java or C++. You can use existing components of let's see, standardized interfaces here, like the FMUs. You can connect to systems with dedicated network models. Yeah. Here, basically, we are supporting general network models, but also automotive-specific network models, for example, the CAN, the FlexRay, LIN and MOS, but also generic ones like Bluetooth or, let's see, wireless connection here or Ethernet connections. In the project now in Values, we are extending that also for dedicated communication protocols for industrial automation, for example, OPC-UA and MQTT. Yeah, we are currently working on that in the use case for together with Pumacy. We also support dedicated host platforms, yeah, with single core, multi core, with different operating systems. If you really want to assess the impact of a certain decision with respect to host platform, the deployment of your applications on the overall system performance, on the basically quality of your concept. So that's also possible. So here we are able to validate your decisions at different levels. Yeah. So you can really see we also go down basically to the really execution platforms, to processor platforms, to operating system. That's also if it's needed, that's possible here if a certain decision has to be taken. And on the other side, there are also means for really connecting conceptual components or existing prototypes or existing codes together to really assess a new concept, to really assess a new feature here. So with respect to the to reference architecture, so when we use the Feral for our virtual continuous integration activities here. So basically what we have is we have the possibility of basically managing and running components in different domains, also to enable nested domains, to really connect components from different domains. For example, a component runs in a time-triggered domain, so a time-triggered component is connected with a event-triggered component or component that really runs in real time. Yeah. So here basically there is the challenge to really synchronize and couple the different behaviors so that you get really then a deterministic behavior out of that. Yeah, so that's the question, okay, how to schedule the components, how to enable the data flow within the system composition here. That's a tool question, it has been solved. Yeah, so really you can use it then for your validation. Yeah, and also the question is, okay, how to connect then the different tools. So there are, as I said, available connectors here for different environments here, so for different tools, different simulation environments. Also, there's the possibility of logging and evaluating system properties. So this means basically you have to assess the data flow in the system, compare it then with your expectation in order to identify issues and then in order to identify violations and failures here. So that's possible by monitoring a logging library here. And also there's a possibility of visualizing aspects here, yeah, because the tool framework is really flexible. So it should be really, we wanted to be able to connect to different environments or to enable the user, different user groups, to connect the tool framework to their tool chain here. So then also the visualization is important. For example, we've used Unity also for visualizing specific data here, but it depends on the use case, yeah. So it's really flexible here, and we covered and solved many questions that come up at this early validation, really when you connect different parts together, yeah, when the single basically the single tool questions or the single simulation models are well covered, yeah, with dedicated tools, with dedicated approaches, but the integration level, the interaction, when you want to connect the things, when you want to combine the things. This really needs a technical infrastructure, sophisticated one, and then Feral is a solution, our solution for that. Yeah. So as I said, we are able to address different levels here. Yeah, for example, also the functional level, that we really come with a model, a distributed a composition of simulation models in order to check especially functional behavior. Yeah, does this a new feature, or is the new feature feasible? Yeah, does it really fit? Does it meet the customer expectations? But if you're interested in more detailed and other quality characteristics, for example, scheduling issues here, or fault injection to hardware, or the performance of your low-level architecture, or let's see, the question of respect to power consumption, then you need other models here, and we are able to integrate these models. Yeah, for example, SystemC, Gem5, and so on. Yeah. That's on the hardware level, also in the action level. We have also connected the Feral tool suite to typical tools like the CANOE or the NS3 simulator here. Now I will talk about some case studies here, because it's always interesting, okay, how this was applied. Yeah, this was basically now the theory and the general introduction, but how it was applied. So basically where we came from, basically our first users of this technology came from the automotive industry here. So here basically you the requirement was to integrate different tools and different platforms via unified API. Yeah. In this case here, the customer wanted to connect, yeah, basically different virtual control units, want to connect the control units that were have been specified in Simulink. There were System C components, Almatea, functional mockup units, and they should be connected in order to enable specific validation. So basically, they are connected via dedicated communication buses. So in the automotive framework, it's then really it's then CAN, FlexRay, also LIN-based networks. So we supported that, and it's part of the library here. Yeah. So then, usually in the project, we developed the connectors here, enabled also the connection via the distributed components and UDP, TCP, or shared memory, and the simulation system is compatible also with different Windows and Linux distributions here. This was also a requirement because then the customer works on different sites, also with different hardware setups. So the simulation should be also supported and should be also executed with different operating systems and platforms here. And here we implement then dedicated functions for the control to simulation, for the connection, the management of synchronization, raw frame coding, and so on. Yeah, so it was really then enabling the customer to simulate complex networks in the automotive domain with several components connected via different buses here in order to develop really new features for the next generation of vehicles. So here's one example here, basically one data flow where different components were exchanging then the data, just to show you how the tool works, visualization here, and basically components were then connected via the UDP, and Feral really worked then as the server, and the master component here, which basically synchronized then the traffic flow and connected in different components here. Yeah. So this was one use case that we had directly from the industry. And basically when we do things, it should have always direct industry impact. So I think that's why it also fits quite well here in the values project, because we developed things that have been already used and proven in real industrial projects here. That's important for us. In the values projects, we are working on dedicated extensions. Yeah. So the setup was then the following here for this project, that then the Feral framework here has been set up. The dedicated bridges and connectors have been created, and we were able then to run the scenarios with these different components and the connection of different tools, basically systemc components interacting with a component that have been designed in MATLAB Simulink. FMUs have been used. And so this was then basically the setup here. The connection was realized then via different virtual communication buses, as I said, like the CAN, FlexRay, and so on. And the customer was then able to design and also validate these new functions. Yeah. So that's a quite nice result here. So then also for the specification of the simulation scenarios, so there are different means. I said we want to be quite flexible in our basically in our tool suite. So basically customers of different groups here, also with different expertise levels, should be able to also define the simulation scenarios. Yeah. And here's one mean of that. So we have dedicated, we call it property files here, where we then define the elements of a simulation scenario. Basically, yeah, what are basically the actors of that? What are their properties? What is the interface? How the interface is connected? What is the general setup of the simulation? Yeah, for example, the duration of the simulation, step time. What is the what is basically the modeling domain of that? Okay, is it time domain, event domain, is it real-time domain? So we are able then to specify the simulation scenario, and basically the whole the generation of the artifact and the deployment of the different artifacts, connection of the artifacts, deployment to the host nodes, that's then automatically done by the tool suite. Yeah, but we have to specify it, but the rest is then automatically. So there are some manual steps, but also several automated steps already. So, and here we just see an example here for the connection, the Simulink. So basically in the Simulink model, we have then also dedicated blocks for the Feral communication, basically then input and output blocks that serves for then the connection with the Feral component, which is then basically, which serves then for the transmission of the data to the other components and the basically coupling of the whole tool infrastructure here. So that's the outcome here, just that when we run the scenarios, so that's already working. So here we see then basically this functionality discretizes then a certain data flow here. It's just a connection that was shown here. So we are really able also to run these scenarios and also tend to evaluate it. Yeah. That's then another point here is our demonstration project here. So we have an internal demonstrator for just trying and developing new features here. It's our advanced driving function validator. Which is basically it's a racing game platform here, the Anki Overdrive, that we will that we have used for the validation of certain concepts here. And here we wanted to use Feral, want to also show the applicability for checking specific driving functions, so advanced driving functions, for example, obstacle detection, automated overtaking, platooning, adaptive cruise control. And we want to connect also then different technical entities here. Here, for example, cameras have been connected. We also can connect the simulation environment with the real devices, with the Anki cars. Basically, it's a Bluetooth connection then. And for us, it's basically then a demonstrator for just trying new concepts and showing them. Yeah, there was a connection to Unity for visualizing that. And so this was a quite nice platform because we have also the direct feedback from the hardware here. Yeah? So we control the cars and we get then basically responses, then the speed and certain other parameters. It's simplified, but I think it's a nice demonstration platform here. So the setup was the following here. We have used another tool for the specification scenarios, Blockly. I will come to that later. We use the Anki Overdrive already for reading the car data and really controlling the car. So we send control commands and reading specific car characteristics here. So we connected the cameras also just to check where the cars are, just to have another data point for the position of the car, which was then more accurate than the ones that we got from the Anki platform. And we had a visualization of the Unity framework here. Yeah. So in that project, we also then developed also dedicated language for specifying the scenarios here. So that's much more detailed than the one that I showed before with this property. So it's really here you can define your the components of the simulation. You can define also interfaces, connections. That's very detailed. So you have really full control of that. And for basically for the engineers that really want to have full control of all components, that's then the choice, basically the domain specific language for the simulation scenario here of that platform. Yeah. So you were able then to connect components, parameterize components, import and exchange connectors here, replace also components. That was then easily possible with that. That's a point. And another point is the specification of the simulation scenario done by Blockly. So some of you might know that it's a graphical programming language, and we use that in order to enable also non-expert users to create a simulation scenario. So basically here they were able to really define a scenario of that racing car. So basically the idea is, okay, if there's an overtaking function with cruise control, how can I basically, it's about configuration, right? About the configuration of the speed, configuration of the behavior, defining thresholds, defining what if conditions, what happens if I reach a certain threshold, if I enter certain safety critical distance or safety distance here, what should happen? Should I change the lane? And here in Blockly, with really simple means, also non-expert users are able to specify these scenarios, which are directly transformed then to a script that is executed then in the Ferrari platform. So that's also a very good result here, that also users with different background and different expertises are enabled to validate things. Yeah, depending on your expertise, depending also on your goals, you can do it at a very low level, very specific, or at a very high level, but you will be then enabled to automatically validate it. Yeah. So for example, here in the red block, the ACC behavior is specified here with respect to speed and the safety distance. So the units are basically here in the millimeters, a millimeter per second. So it's different because our world basically is defined like that basically distances are measured in millimeters, and also speed is then in measured in millimeters per second and not in meters per second. Yeah, to also use then integer values here. So there's another part with respect to the car detection avoidance. So basically, that's another threshold tier that usually covers this overtake. Yeah, the question is then, when should the car follow the leading car, or when should I overtake? And then I can configure that. Yeah. And here we see then one scenario. Basically, two cars are configured here, the blue one and the red one, with different basically values here with respect to the speed. Yeah, and so let's look at this figure here, how this really works. So in one scenario here, so we have a dedicated safety distance and a dedicated basically distance for the overtaking. And here the ACC safety distance is 800 millimeters, the CDA safety distance, so basically for overtaking, is shorter. So basically when you approach the leading car here, then the ACC safety distance is entered first. Yeah, so basically, and you would follow that. Yeah, so ACC is triggered first, so we follow that. If we configure it in a different way, basically that the overtaking distance, yeah, to avoid the collision here, the CDT safety distance is greater, then basically would expecting different behavior. Yeah, here CDT safety distance reached already at 80 at 800 millimeters. So then the car would overtake, because the one has then the higher speed, 800 millimeters per second, the car would then overtake. And I would not enter this ACC controlling mode here. Yeah? So I can really try out different configurations of the system, yeah, play really with the numbers and assess my design and configuration alternatives. Yeah? This was what we wanted to do here. There were several other scenarios, also with traffic on the other lanes, what happens then with the traffic, also with the basically number of cars, the frequency, and so on. So different really scenarios could be considered. So we were able then also to use then Ferrari in this context, connected to real components here, yeah, with really with the real sensors and real actuators, even if it were a racing game. But we are also able to connect them. And that for us was an important also demonstrator showcase to really to show that, yeah. Yeah. So we applied it in several demonstrators here in the values project. We are working on the on industrial automation use cases here, especially use case for with Pumacy, where we do not deal with cars, but with robots, robot models, and also sensors of these robots. So then it's a question of how basically the data flow can be represented, how the dedicated two communication networks are presented here. And so it's a different setup, but the challenge is something like similar. We want to early validate new concepts here with dedicated tools, dedicated environments, and we want to able to connect it and to validate it and to assess specific characteristics. Yeah. So basically then it's a question of, okay, are there additional tools, additional communication networks that have to be supported, but the general setup, the general idea is the same. Yeah. So just to summarize then, the talk here, basically at the beginning, we talked about the need for the shift left and the virtual validation. So here we really want to enable the customers to early validate their concepts, their requirements, their new features. Now we will do that with our Ferrari system here, which is a flexible framework for connecting components, for coupling different tools. We have a set of components in our library that are already available here, also for the projects, with different kinds of component models, different kind of network models, different kind also of fault injection models here. And we have also different means for specifying a scenario. Yeah, textual means, also then the graphical languages here with the Blockly. So the different means depending on the user group. And here in the values, basically we're extending it also with respect to the automation, with respect to the component types, network types that are needed also for different domains. Yeah. Thank you.